Hello, my name is Frank DiStasi, and I'm an applications engineer at Texas Instruments. And today I'll be highlighting the trade-offs between small solution size and good thermal performance using one of our latest wide VIN range buck regulators, the LMR33630. This device is offered in two different packages, a small 2mm by 3mm QFN and a 4mm by 5mm SOIC. Essentially, the QFN package, not only being very small, also has no bond wires, which means you don't have a lot of noise generated, which makes it easier for you to pass your conducted and radiated EMI. In addition, the QFN package has wettable flanks and a step cut around the bottom of the package, which allows a large solder fillet to form, which makes it easier for you to ensure that you're getting a good solder joint. For the SOIC package, there's a very large thermal slug on the bottom of the package that gets soldered down to the PC board, which gives very, very good thermal performance and very low R theta JC. Also, this package, being a leaded package, is a little bit easier to hand solder, which makes rework a little bit easier should the need arise to rework your PC board. We see here both ICs in their different packages on two EVMs. The EVMs are essentially the same size with the same BOM and the same components. And today we're going to take a look and compare the thermal performance between these two packages, hopefully in an apples-to-apples type of comparison. The application we'll be looking at is 24 volts in, 5 volts out, and 3 amps of load current. This is very typical for an industrial-type application with a 400 kHz switching frequency. The equipment that we'll use is an input power supply, an active load, and several DMMs to measure the input and output parameters of our regulator. Also, we have a thermal camera set up to look at the top case temperature of both packages so that we can determine what that temperature rise will be. So there are a few things you have to remember when you're going to make an accurate thermal measurement. First of all, you have to make sure that there aren't any air currents flowing around your EVM that could artificially cool down your actual measurement. Usually we have some kind of a barrier, like a box, around the EVM surrounding it so that air currents don't actually try to cool down the board artificially. Second thing you have to remember is you have to wait long enough for the junction temperature to reach its steady state. This might take 15 to 20 minutes on a board this size, but once you've waited long enough, then you can be assured that the junction temperature has stabilized and you know you have a good reading. The other thing to keep in mind is that the camera we have here is actually measuring the top case temperature. It's not measuring the exact junction temperature. In order to go from the case temperature to the junction temperature, we need to make a very simple calculation. So if I turn on my power supply and my load, we're now all set up for the camera to take a look at the top case temperature. On the slide, you see the difference between the two temperatures, between the two different packages. It's easy to see that the SOIC package is quite a bit cooler than the QFN package, which is really the basic trade-off. On the next slide, we see how to calculate the actual junction temperature. The equation at the bottom of the slide allows us to do that. To use the equation, we need the power dissipation, and we need a parameter called PsiJT. PsiJT is found in the datasheet for the device, and the power dissipation is calculated using the measurements that we just saw here in the lab from our DMMs. So, after making the calculation, we see that the QFN junction temperature is about 65 degrees C, whereas the SOIC junction temperature is about 52 degrees C. That's almost a 15 degree difference, and that can make quite a difference in many applications. So in summary, with the right package, one device can give you both small solution size and good thermal performance. If you need a 1.5 amp solution or a 600 milliamp solution, take a look at the LMR36015 or the LMR36006. For more information, please visit ti.com, and thank you for watching.